Hi there, welcome to another video from Hegarty Mathis. Mr. Hegarty here. Our fifth video on conditional probability, where we do some slightly more advanced work. Let's start with an idea we should already be familiar with. Now, previously I've shown this to you. If you assume A and B are dependent events, and assume A happens first, we can always draw the following tree diagram. The first thing you can do is you can consider the case when A happens or A doesn't happen, with probability P of A or P of not A. Now, subsequent to that, let's think about whether B happens or not. So assuming we go down the line that A did happen in the first instance, let's assume, we can say, well, B can happen or not happen with probability. Now, this is important, B given A. So this is the probability that B happens given we've gone down the branch for A. And this is the probability B doesn't happen given we've gone down the branch for A. Or we could have thought to ourselves, initially the A doesn't happen, and if A doesn't happen, we would get the following. And this is the probability B doesn't happen given A didn't happen, and this is the probability B does happen given A didn't happen. So we have to label up our diagram like that, and we know we can multiply along the branches of the probability tree diagram. So we know that the probability of A and B happening is the probability of A multiplied by the probability of B given A, and etc. The probability of A and not B is the probability of A multiplied by the probability of B not B given A. Okay, and we would multiply along, etc., to get all of these. Now, the one I want us to focus in on is this one, which we're going to be talking about more in a second. The probability of A and B is the probability of A happening multiplied by the probability of B given A. Now, that does make some sort of sense. Obviously, it's from the tree diagram here, but think about it. If you're assuming A happened first, the probability of A and B happening is the probability of A happening multiplied by the probability of then B happening given you know A happened. So that kind of makes sense. Now, that was, of course, assuming A happened first. We could have done it the other way around and made B happen first, and we would have got the following picture. It's exactly the same idea here, and you would get these probabilities along here by multiplying along. This multiplied by this here gives you the probability of A and B. Now, just to note, the probability of B and A is the same as A and B. You could have written it the other way around. You could have written this the other way around as follows. It doesn't make a difference to what way around you write it, what probabilities they are, okay? Now, again, the key formula I want us to focus in on is this one here. The probability of A and B is the probability of B multiplied by the probability of A given B. Again, it kind of makes sense. For A and B to happen, assuming B happens first, you do the probability of B, because it happened first, multiplied by the probability of A given B happened. All right? So let's take those two formulae I've presented to you and try and learn them. So for any events A and B, we can state the following. From our diagrams, we can say the probability of A and B is either, thinking of it as A happening first, the probability of A happening multiplied by the probability of B happening given A happened. Or we could think of B happening first, the probability of A and B is the probability of B happening first multiplied by then the probability of A happening given B happened. All right, and they come from our two diagrams. This is the first one, this is the second one, and these are our two formulae here. Now, sometimes it actually turns out we like to make that the subject of the formula. If we divided both sides in this case by the probability of A, we would get that the probability of B given A is probability of A and B divided by the probability of A. That's just this formula rearranged, and sometimes we like it written with that the subject of the formula, so dividing both sides by the probability of B, and we would get the following. Now, students tend to find this easier to remember, this one, and it's often written in textbooks like this. It's because always on the top, doesn't matter whether it's A given B or B given A, you always have the probability of A and B on top. And if it's probability of B given A, the slash A means the probability of A is on the bottom. If it's probability of A slash B, the slash B means probability of B is on the bottom. Okay, and we have to learn these formulae because we're going to be using them throughout this video. So let's get on and try some questions. So here's the first one. Pause the video and have a go. Right, we want the probability of A given B. Let's see if we can remember the formula. A given B, remember, it's always probability of A intercept B on the top. And if it's slash B, there's probability of B on the bottom. Now, do we have that? Well, we have this one, and we have this one here. So what we're doing is 1/5 divided by a half. 1/5 divided by a half. Dividing by a fraction is the same as multiplying by its reciprocal. That's the same as doing the following, in which case you'd get 2/5. This one here, well, the probability of B given A is always on the top, probability of A and B, but slash A means probability of A on the bottom. So we know this, it's 1/5, and we're doing 1/5 divided by 1/3. That's the same as 1/5 multiplied by 3/1, which is 3/5, and we're done. Okay, next one, pause video, have a go. Right, events A and B are such that the following is true. Find the probability of A given B. Same thing, let's just state our formula first. Always probability of A and B on the top. Slash B means probability of B on the bottom. So do we have that? Yes, we do. We're going to do 0.3 divided by 0.4. And that's simply 3/4, which is 0.75. This one here, writing the formula the other way around, is always probability of A and B on top. Because it's slash A, we have probability of A on the bottom. So this would be 0.3 from up here divided by 0.5, and that's just 3/5, which is 0.6, we should know. Next question, pause and have a go. Right, let's write our formula for these. The probability of not A given B must be the probability of not A and B over the probability of B. Do we have those informations? We have this one, it's going to be 1/10 divided by 3/10. And 1/10 divided by 3/10 is 1/3 when you work it out. And we're done. And this one here, let's write our formula. That's going to be the probability of B intercept not A all over the probability of not A. Now, do we have the top number? Yeah, that's the same. It doesn't matter what way around you write it. So we're doing 1/10 divided by the probability of not A. Well, the probability of A is 1/2. The probability of not A is 1, subtract that, which also must be 1/2. So we will do 1/10 divided by 1/2, which works out as 2/10, which simplifies to 1/5, and we're done. Okay, next question. Have a go at this. Okay, we're asked to find the probability of A and B, so it's slightly different to the others. I look here and I think to myself, well, I've got the probability of A, the probability of B, the probability of A given B, and I want the probability of A and B. Maybe I should write a formula that I know with this one, and it will help me out. Now, I do know that the probability of A given B, though I find it easier to remember it like this, is the probability of A intercept B divided by the probability of B. Therefore, if I want to find this one out, I know that the probability of A intercept B is the probability of B multiplied by the probability of A given B. Now, you could also just remember it like that. Remember I said you can think of this as the A, B happening first, so the probability of B multiplied by then probability of A happening given B happen. So if you remember it just straight to there, that is great too. So we want this, so all we've got to do, we've got the probability of B, which is 3/4, multiplied by this one, we've got A given B, which is 1/5, multiplying fractions, multiply numerators, multiply denominators, you get 3/20, and you're done. Next one, pause and have a go. Again, I would look at that and I'd say, right, I want the probability of A and B. I've got B given A, so I know these two are in a formula together. Why don't I write down this formula for this? The probability of B given A is the probability of A and B, always like that on the top, divided by the probability of A. Rearranging to make this the subject, because this is what I want to find, the probability of A intercept B is the probability of A multiplied by the probability of B given A. Again, you may just remember it to that line straight away. So that you're going to do 0.7 multiplied by 0.2, and you get yourself 0.14, and you're done. Next one. Pause, have a go. Okay, similar stuff here. I can see I've got the probability of B given not A. I want the probability of not A and B. I find it helpful to write the formula for this one down. So that's the probability of B given not A is the probability of not A and B divided by the probability of not A. Now, rearranging to make that the subject, because that is after all what I want, the probability of not A and B is therefore the probability of not A multiplied by the probability of B given not A. Again, you may have remembered it straight at that point. So therefore, Well, we've got the probability of A is 0.6. The probability of not A must be 1, subtract this, it'll be 0.4. So all you would do here is 0.4 multiplied by this that you've got here, 0.1, and you get yourself 0.04, and you're done. Last question, pause and have a go. Similar to before, I look at that, I've got that piece of information there, so let me write the formula for this. The probability of not B given not A is the probability of not A intercept not B all over the probability of not A. Now, I want to find this thing, so I make that the subject of the formula. And the probability of not A is 1 subtract 2/5, which will be 3/5. So all I've got to do is do 3/5 multiplied by the other one I've got, which is 1/4. And when you do that, 3 times 1 is 3 over 5 multiplied by 4 is 20, and you're done. And that's it for this video. Thanks loads for watching.